Hey friends, welcome back to Bitfumes. I'm your host Sarthak and you can also call me Ankur. This is a channel where I talk about Laravel and the cool thing about Laravel. So if you are new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe. That's a very important thing. So first of all, very happy Holi to everyone and especially the Indian subscribers. So the second thing is I want to thank you Vedas Gudas for donating an amount on paypal.me/bitfumes. This shows your love and support towards the Bitfumes and it encouraged me to create more and more professional videos for you to help you. And I'm not asking for any amount, but if you want to donate, please go to the link and provide it in the description. So in this episode, what we are going to do is, obviously we are on the authentication series and next step will be the email verification of the user. But before that, I want to show you how to log in with a status. That means if a status of a user is not active, then it will be not able to log in. If the status is yes, the status is 1, then it can log in with no error. So let's log in with our original system. So I will go to this login button. Now here I will type my email ID and let's see the error because password is incorrect. 111111. Enter. Oh yes, we are logged in successfully. So let's see the database. We will go to the server. Now we are on our server and let's go to the users table. And here is the users table. And you can see there is no status column. So let's go to structure and create that column so that we can easily manipulate the user login. So I will add after last name. So go here. I will type status and the status will be a Boolean thing because we want just 0 or the 1. Okay. So let's save it. And now you can see the user is not an active member because its status is 0. So when we try to log in now, because we does not have provided any system for preventing the login with status. So when I go here and I'm trying to log in, I will easily logged in. So you can see we are easily logged in, but for this changes, we will go to the Sublime Text. And we are on our auth folder where we are working on an authentication series. So let's go to the app folder, the HTTP folder, controller and the auth folder. You can see there is a login controller. Go to this login controller. Okay. And you can see it's using a authenticate users file. So let's go to that file inside the vendor Laravel framework source illuminate foundation auth authenticate users. So if you are using Sublime, it will be easy. So let's click here and now go to the bottom and you will find a function called credentials. Let's just copy this function and now paste this function inside your login controller. That means we are actually overriding this function. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to comment out this line. Okay, and now I am returning an array which says email will be, obviously we want the email to the same as this. Okay, and the password will be the requested password. That means the password given by the user. So okay, next thing is I want to give a status of value 1. Okay, so now let's see what happened. Obviously there is an error, but I will show that error after this thing. So let's go to the Chrome and try to log in again. Let's log out and try to log in. Let's see what happened. 111111. And you can see there is an error because we have not imported the request. So let's go here, the authenticate users, copy this and use that request here. Okay, save this, go to Chrome click refresh, and okay, we can see there is an error 1111111. So you can see we are actually giving a status of 1, but we have the status of 0 here. So let's go and change it to 1. That means we are still having some error, but if we try to log in, let's see what the result is. 1111. So obviously we are not able to log in. Why? Because there is a change in our system where we have created. We actually have to create this. We actually have to say request, then arrow, and obviously we have to wrap this inside a curly braces. Now when I go here and type 111111 the password, hit enter, and now you can see we are successfully logged in. So let's try to log in again. Log in again. 111111, and we are logged in. Now let's try to change the status to 0. That means not active person. Now when I go here into login system, try to log in. 111111. Hit enter, and you can see there is an error. Credential does not match our record. That means we have successfully created a system where user has to verify its status. That means if the user is not an active person, it will not able to log in. This is very much beneficial in our next system when we are trying to verify the user by its email, by sending an email. Okay, so before sending email, we will set the status to 0, and when the user verifies its email, then we will change the status to 1. So if you have any doubt, please feel free to comment, and if you have any doubt in any of my video and anywhere in your project, please feel free to comment and feel free to message me on Facebook. I'm always ready to respond you, and thank you guys, because we have successfully reached more than 650 subscriber mark here on YouTube. So thank you everyone. Please share this video with your developer friend. Follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, and we'll meet in the next episode. Till then, be happy. Goodbye.